So this week we are going to talk about the IPL. I'm sure some of you just said, oh no, not again. No, we are not going to be talking about the IPL auction itself. We are going to talk about the IPL itself. So once again, let me welcome Bala. Bala, hi, welcome.
Yeah, cheery morning, Raj.
And not so cheery in Bangalore. It's quite dull, but then cheery, yes. So we'll go with
dull
that.
In terms of weather, right?
Yes. So how did you see IPL panning out? Because we both were part of that journey, or many of us were. So how did you see this panning out from 2008 or even before that when ICL came into the play? Exactly. So over to you.
See, all yeah. time is, yeah, the scene was planted with India actually winning the 2007 World Cup. I mean, it was not exactly termed the T20 World Cup. It was the World Championship kind of a thing. There was no exact World Cup. The World Cup board was
correct.
Yeah, the fact that India won gave the impetus. Just as 1983 win for India in the ODI gave a much needed fillip for the shorter version of the game in the all through the 80s and the 90s. The T20s got a head start with India, because India getting a head start is pretty much important, because you have the numbers in terms of public cricket crazy by public and the marketing muscle. See, at the end of the day, cricket is run by few people with money. It is, I mean, whether we like it or not, that is the fact. So, yeah, just as we were discussing ahead of the show, it was kind of a, because even before IPL started, ICL, there was something called ICL. I mean, it got banned and everybody knows that. I mean, that story is that, because it was started by people who are not part of the ICC and BCCI. So, it got banned and there were other issues also. But IPL, when it started, you made a good point offline, because it was initially thought of as a kind of a league for the elderly, as a kind of a pension scheme. That was original, I mean, yeah, not the original idea, original thought in certain people. From yeah, that to the place where it is right now, because it is now seen as the top wear of all the great talent in world cricket, especially in the shorter form. It is the beacon for the rest of the world.
So let us break it down. I mean, I think you got very euphemistic there about IPL. So let us break that down into exactly what happened here. That was like I don't think even Lalit Modi could have done a better better publicity for IPL. You just nailed it, man. So I'm just breaking that down. I mean, I don't know how many of us remember the earliest of IPLs where you actually had Tendulkar, who didn't play T20 for India. Rahul Dravid, I think, I don't know whether he played one T20, I don't remember. Sourav Ganguly was completely unfit for T20 because our man couldn't run between the wickets. So I mean, you actually had a bunch of people who were not fit for T20, and they were the icon players for the teams. So, and when that happened, then you actually brought Glenn McGrath out of retirement. Adam Gilchrist came out of, I mean, he was probably resting. He had his feet up and suddenly you saw him coming in. I mean, you saw some of the cricketers who were just
in the fag end of their careers. You're right.
Yes, fag end of their careers, or who had retired. Shane Warne came out of retirement. He actually won the bloody IPL for Rajasthan Royals. So this was the way it is. And I remember having conversations with my friends and colleagues that time and saying that, oh, you know what? Yeh toh achha hai. I mean, retired cricketers can come and play, because, I mean, the bowlers need to bowl only 4 overs. I mean, anybody can do that. And batting, it's okay. I mean, 20 overs, no, you can bat 3-4 overs, get out, and the next fellow will come and bat. So these were the conversations that happened. And so from that point, when we saw IPL, we said, it's okay, it's a tournament. But then, it's pajama cricket at its, I mean, the Indian version of pajama cricket, which was started by Kerry Packer in the late 70s and 80s, 70s, if I remember right. 70s. Yeah. So, I mean, that was actually, I mean, Kerry Packer cricket is another story for some other time, but it was basically a resistance. And I believe ICL also was like that. And some of the big names joined ICL, including Kapil Dev. So, I mean, I just want to remind you viewers of that. Got banned, and then BCCI gave them amnesty. All of that happened.
Just a small trivia. One of the stars of the ICL, Ambati Raidu, is still around in the IPL.
Yeah, there you go. So, this form of cricket. So, from that point, the way it moved forward, Bala, like you said, was that Today, if you notice, look at the number of players who actually used IPL and played cricket. The latest memory, of course, which is fresh in all our minds, is Natarajan, T. Natarajan, who failed in the IPL in the previous edition, did well in this edition, and suddenly is part of all three formats of Indian cricket. So that is the journey. What's
that's
your
the point? Because T. Natarajan is a good case in point, because it is not just us. Even Brijesh Patel, in his inaugural remarks, thought it fit to bring up his name during the IPL auction. So, I mean, Natarajan is just one example. There are countless examples. And I'm not just talking about young cricketers who have obvious talent and raring to go. Somebody like Pravin Tambe, 40+, he has made good use of IPL and he has managed to go on to other leagues. One of the few Indian players who has managed to make a mark in other leagues. Like in the Caribbean League. So, it is not just for the young cricket. So, the great thing about IPL is, it is also about, I mean, not the talent, not just for the young. If you have certain skills, you can go out and exhibit. I mean, I may not say it is a market economy. You will again tell me that I am talking euphemistically, but these are the good points of market economy.
See, I agree. See, simply put, it's look at it this way. I mean, you need a private enterprise to make this an enterprise. There's no way that this could have been created and managed without the private enterprise, without the money of the big guns who are there, your Ambanis, your Shah Rukh Khans, Preeti Zinta and gang, and I mean, the franchise owners. So, those people...
Sorry, just a minute. My internet got cut. Now it is back. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, so I was saying, Bala, that I mean, this wouldn't have been proxy. When you're talking about corporatizing cricket, you need the corporates. So, exactly. I mean, you can always look at some of these things. I mean, there have been allegations of, late night parties and all of those things. I mean, if it is happening, it shouldn't happen. Okay, we all agree on that. Let us not, labor that point. The point is that look at the number of people who have actually got fantastic careers. The latest one you saw was Shah Rukh Khan. I don't know enough of his background, but then the guy got 5 crores. So,
exactly.
So I think for me that was a big moment. I mean, how do you
see that's that a good thing that you it's a good thing you brought about Shah Rukh Khan. I think a lot of people would have seen the video of Shah Rukh Khan traveling with the Tamil Nadu cricket team while the auction was on. And when the bid was going through the roof for him, the entire Tamil Nadu team was happy for him.
Yeah.
They were happy with every moment the bid was going up for him. So, there was genuine happiness. And here was an youngster who comes from a typical middle-class background. I mean, not too bad like Natarajan. But he comes from middle class. For him to get the kind of money that he's getting. And he now not only has the money, he has a stage to show parade his wares. He can go out and show his skills. So, those things are very, as an youngster, these things are very important. The auctions may have thrown the spotlight on big names like Chris Morris, Maxwell, and those things are fine. But I'm more interested in guys like, Hari Nishan, Shah Rukh Khan. I'm talking purely from a Tamil Nadu point of view.
Let us expand it.
That's what I'm coming to. There are other examples from other states also, because
Sony, we'll give some. I was reading about Chetan Salaria, who's a Sakaria. Sorry, I mean, I'm not, I even got the name wrong. So I mean, this guy was a bowler, the family had nothing. And why go so far? I mean, you had Mohammad Siraj, whose father is an auto rickshaw driver, right? I mean, so look at the examples around. I mean, the fact
even
that we can, yeah, sorry,
even tiny.
Signing, So there's so many of these cricketers who actually came in and made that field their own. Some of them came and faded away. I mean, you had some terrific performers who were one. Some of us might remember Paul Valthati, and there was this Swapnil Asnodkar who came in. I mean, a Goan player. I mean, he cracked his. Both these fellows, they will be in the annals of IPL history because both of them scored centuries. So
Exactly. And that is also a misconception that some of the skills that these guys exhibit are only for the shorter version. version of the game. It is not necessarily the case, because your biggest name in Indian cricket is your Jasprit Bumrah, and he made his mark. He announced his arrival only through IPL, and that is through the talent scout program that Mumbai Indians had. So that is how he was unearthed.
Now, let us look at it. I mean, just see. Now, you mentioned Jasprit Bumrah. I mean, the same goes with the Pandya brothers also, no?
Exactly.
So, Hardik Pandya, who came into the team, Hardik probably landed, I mean, a season before Jasprit. Same case, same scenario. The guy was there and suddenly you found him out, I mean, sort of taking things up. And if you look at it, see, I think Cheteshwar Pujara, so who was kept out of IPL for so long because everybody had a particular idea. This time when Pujara actually was auctioned for his base price, the hall, there was clapping and people took to social media.
That is good to say. Yeah. The spontaneous response to, I mean, Cheteshwar Pujara being out of the blue, being picked by CSK.
Yeah.
There are also inevitable jokes around that. But the clapping showed the kind of esteem that Cheteshwar Pujara enjoys among the cricketing cognoscenti.
Yeah.
At the same time, there is also a message. Nothing is ever lost.
Correct. So, see, I think to me, that is the beauty of IPL. So, see, I mean, now if we sort of go further down, another criticism of the IPL, like you said, Bala, you brought it in briefly, was that the players who sort of come into IPL, they lose their zing in other forms of cricket. This has been the other criticism of IPL, where you say that, oh, you know what, after the IPL, test matches are not going 5 days, people are just coming and whacking their bats, they are not able to hang in. So, I mean, let us dissect that. Let us sort of figure out whether it is really true. So, one thing I'll say before I hand it over to you, Bala, is that, yes, cricket matches, you are not having dull, dreary draws after 5 days, test matches. So, but the question is that a bad thing? Over to you.
No, in terms of numbers also, when you look at the stats, a lot of matches all through this, the Australia-India series was a classic. Most of the matches, except for the Adelaide test, went to the last day. So the numbers don't really match it. Even among the last two tests that India and England played, first test went to the fifth day. The second test was over on the fourth day. So these things do last. But and it's just not about the number of days that a test match extends to. The skills that test cricketers exhibit, the skill, the physical fitness, the speed at which, because the way they approach a test match innings, the way they approach a test match bowling.
So let us break that down also. Let us break that down.
Those things have improved.
What I'm saying. Let us break that down. I mean, we talk about, people ask, how was it improved? First question, look at the fielding that you see in a test match on a regular basis today. When you have a similar type of catches being taken, you have fantastic fielding. Even have people like Ashwin, who is considered to be a little slow on the field. I mean, his fitness levels this time is...
That is a fact.
Yeah. So, this time his fitness levels seem to be different. I mean, when you look at him,
exactly,
he looks sinewy today, this time. I mean, I'm using the word specifically. So, he actually had a couple of good fielding, good stops against England in the recently concluded match in Chennai. So, the point is, that is one, Bala. Aren't there others? I mean, I want you to talk about the running between the wickets.
Batting ability. See, you see a lot of sixes being hit. See, you have Gill, or Rohit Sharma has been a six hitter all through his career. Somebody like Shubman Gill, and of course, Rishabh Pant. See, his sixes being aggregate is among the best in the world. It's, in terms of all-time level, he's only just behind Adam Gilchrist. It's not just about sixes hitting.
Why not Ashwin? I mean, we all talk about Sehwag hitting sixes to get to the century.
Not just Ashwin. Even your Siraj.
I know.
Exactly. That is what, those things matter in a test match. Those six hitting abilities were the clinchers for India to win that Brisbane test. So, it is not a one-off example. That's a very good example. That is a case in point. So, all through this last, say, six or seven series, what I have been seeing is the skills of T20 have come to impact test match, which is very good. Test matches have become more interesting. See, you have fourth inning chases. You have see all these great fourth inning chases that involve Sushant Mendes or Ben Stokes or Rishabh Pant. These are all these have happened in the time of T20. This kind of fourth inning chases, exciting chases, where one person just goes out and knocks the hell out of the opposition bowler. These have been become consistent in the last 5-6 years. And that is the real victory of T20 cricket, of which IPL is the flag bearer.
Correct. I totally agree with you. I mean, when there is this polarization that has happened over IPL, which is why we thought we'll do this program, because when the auctions happened, when even I tweeted, I just said, you know what, where else but give me an example of any other place where your performance is not linked to your salary, where the lower you perform, the better your salary gets. I was taking a crack at Glenn Maxwell of Australia and Krishnappa Gautam of India, who are both guys who are good players, definitely excellent players. They have not had great IPLs till now, which might change. So, that was just a crack. But let us understand this. I think, Bala, I think your point about how IPL, the shorter auctions in IPL or smaller auctions generate this kind of stock marketish behavior. So, I want you to just sort of share your thoughts on that.
Exactly, because as I was saying, the whole thing is the shorter options, because every team goes just to plug a few spots in the team, because the buyer land, the bulk of the team is already fixed. The only the smaller holes that needed to be fixed, they are being attended to. And that is what happens. So, in such a smaller option, these kind of skewed bidding, where one person gets disproportionately high bid, that was always on the cards. But having said that, kind of money that they eventually ended up was kind of mind-boggling. Because 16 plus crores for Chris Morris. See, as somebody put out a tweet saying that was the kind of money that the entire South African cricketing administration would have made if the Australian series against Australia had gone ahead.
Yeah.
That kind of tells the tale. Because at the end of the day, 16 point plus crores for a single person who is not even commanding a regular place in his international team, does seem unseemly.
Yes, same holds good for a few other international players also. So, you have, what is that, Meredith, what's his name? Riley Meredith.
These guys are talented players, yeah.
Yeah, that no doubt about that. So, the point, and then you have Kylie Jameson of New Zealand. I don't think he has stepped out of New Zealand till now, but then today he's at a different place. I think I read somewhere Meredith was talking to his fiance or girlfriend and saying, no, this can't be true. He had doubts that this is not right. I mean, he's hearing it wrong.
The other tweet was very interesting. When Sam Bennett, in the initial round when he went unsold, his girlfriend apparently said that you should have been a bowler.
yeah, that was also there. How come you are not a bowler? Why are you a wicketkeeper? and then look at it this way. See, you had two players who one of them didn't turn up last year. The second one didn't turn up. He turned up last year, but didn't turn up as a player. And both of them happened to be from your team, CSK. And both of them got base price. So, that is interesting again. One is Kedar, one is Harbhajan. So,
surprised the kind of bids for Piyush Chawla.
Yeah. So, Piyush Chawla got bid. So, see, what I'm saying is that, this is a question of, at the end of the day, this is a journey where the cricketers are finding it useful to play cricket. So, this time, we might look at somebody like a Yashasvi Jaiswal, who was actually selling, bread pakoda or golgappa or something in Panipuri in Bombay. So, he is part of the team. We spoke about Nataraj and we spoke about Zakaria. There are so many cases where guys who probably would have spent their time, playing gully cricket or something, suddenly they find themselves in the spotlight. Now, there is a flip side to it. Yeah, there is a flip side to it, which we will mention and then end the show, I think.
What these short options also do is, they generally value. See, if you are a batting player, batsman, come on, off-spinner, they value that. Whether you actually exhibit the skills on a cricketing field, that is not taken into consideration. So, sometimes that is what happens. Because they just go by the capability that is on paper.
Correct.
So sometimes
correct.
that is not, I mean, you correctly said that it is stock marketing. That is the
yes.
word. Because that doesn't reflect the intrinsic value of a company. Because
correct.
That is slightly in a parallel track. Because that is not a barometer for to check the reliability or the entire the real health of a company. So this
yeah.
is also slightly similar to that.
Yeah, so which is where I'm coming to the final point, which I want to bring in, because I think people should be aware of this. Anyone who watches, I mean, is watching this or who would watch it in the future, I mean, I want to just put it on record that, I mean, I've seen this early morning when I go past Chinnaswamy in Bangalore, when I'm going to Kabban Park for a walk or something like that. I see a lot of young players who are sort of who are coming up to practice there, and I can assure you, I mean my Kannada is not very good. Apologies for that. I've been in Bangalore for quite a while. In my broken Kannada, I sometimes speak to these kids, and all of them are looking to play IPL. They are not looking to play for Karnataka. Forget Indian team, for Karnataka. And today, they are not even looking to play IPL. They are looking to play KPL, which is good enough to take those people out from the social position they are today into the next level. So, I'm not saying this is a bad thing. It's a fantastic thing. But what is required is a little bit of mentoring and training for these players so that they have an alternate in case something doesn't work. So I think that is where it is, because I saw guys who were very upset. They said 4-5 years I've been slogging, I have not got anything. So those people are also there. So the success stories are there. At the same time, there is also something that we need to look at, which is the story of people who are not successful. Bala, what do you say to that?
That is the kind of cautionary tale that everybody should be aware of. Good thing that you brought that up. Because IPL, if you understand one thing, it is what has IPL done is also take cricket away from this traditional center. See, even in this IPL, this particular action, you would have seen a lot of Kerala players getting sold, which is Kerala, as we all know, is not a regular center for cricket. Volleyball, football, athletics, that is what Kerala is generally known for. So it is actually good that some of these smaller places, and not just Kerala, see, you have from UP, smaller towns in UP, MP. I mean, of course, we all know that MS Dhoni made his mark from Jharkhand. So those things we all know. So when people from these smaller places, the so-called places that are not traditionally in the spotlight, that's bad, because when players from there come up the ranks, they also need mentoring. Because, especially in case of failure, because you rightly said, when the spotlight is there, the spotlight is bound to be there only of the selected few. There will be countless number of people who will be left out. And they need a certain amount of shepherding. They need to be handheld and taken through the, because, see, let's face it, at the end of the day, the failures are not going to be talked. They are going to be beside the headlines. So those people need help. And we all hope there is some kind of a program to keep them in some kind of an understanding position of understanding. Because these things do happen.
Yeah, so I think we'll just conclude with, I'll just conclude with this one word. I mean, I remember reading and I remember seeing Rahul Dravid, who's played a fantastic, phenomenal role in the way the players have developed over the years, over the last 7-8 years. I mean, Ravi Shastri and Virat Kohli, both of them sing praises of this guy, because he's the one who brought up this India A and under-19 things, under-19 championship, I mean, cricketers. So many of them are playing for India today. So, Rahul Dravid did mention once that, you know what, I think there needs to be skill training for players who are coming in by the hordes to attend the state cricket association camps and stuff like that. I mean, as a key person in NCAA, maybe he can take a role in this also, because, I mean, he's a sort of an idol for aspiring cricketers all over, not just in India, but I think globally. I remember watching Inzamam ul Haq going gaga over how Indian cricketers are, I mean, India is producing cricketers by the dozen where Pakistan has lost. And he said that maybe you should give Rahul Dravid a small stint so that he can develop Pakistan cricket. So, I mean, so I think we'll wind up with that, because I think that's a very, very
sobering
thought.
Sobering thought is that the local state associations have a role
yes.
to play, because
yes.
they are in touch with the grassroots players. And unfortunately, for all the success stories, the kind of things that we have spoken about IPL, the real problem is our own state association, because much of them are mired in corruption and infighting. The less said, the better. You know it. You come from the worst place, Delhi. So
yes.
that's where the problem is.
Yeah, so maybe, so we'll just leave with this thought then. I mean, I was thinking of leaving with a sobering thought. Maybe we'll leave with an uplifting thought, which is that maybe the cricketer, I mean, maybe the players who own the IPLs, they can be invited and involved in the state associations also, even the smaller ones. You don't need, I mean, corporatize the state cricket also. I think maybe that is the answer, Bala.
Perhaps, see, once they go into the state association, somebody like Saurav Ganguly started the state association, now he's in the national association. So, they immediately get sucked into the bigger thing. But one of those things, because you can't have everything. There will always be room for improvement. That's where we think IPL is headed. There will be room for improvement, for especially for the people who get left out, who don't get those headlines.
Yes, I think on that note, we'll wind up. Thanks for watching, and share your views with us. What do you think about the IPL? What are your views? And reach out, and we'll be glad to take your questions, or we'll be glad to have you on the show. We have said that before. We have podcasts of our own. We are on Spotify and Apple. So that's it. That's Tweak the Week for this week. Bala, thanks for being part of the show. And
absolutely,
we'll see you next week. We'll see you next week with something else. Till then, stay safe. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.